Today I'm going to look inside of this ceiling fan speed controller that I demonstrated behaving weirdly with a fan in the last video. This was originally installed and used for a ceiling fan and light combination. It has a switch to select between low, off, and high brightness for the light, and a selector to select four speeds and off for the fan. It uses three wires, one for power, one for sending power to the light, another for sending power to the fan. However, an interesting thing to note is that it is designed for use with controlling ceiling fans, and that it worked just fine with the fan that it was controlling when it was installed. But now I will take a look inside of this. This front plate is held on with two screws, which I will remove. And now, what? Something seems to be holding it together. And now we can see what is inside of it. There is a large diode, a resistor, some capacitors in there, and another resistor. This is what the back of the circuit board looks like. It appears that these capacitors are being used to control the speed of the fan. And this diode might be used for providing the low brightness to the light. By sending the power to the light bulb through the diode, it can run it at half power, but it is definitely not the best way to dim a light bulb. And depending on the speed selection, the power that goes to the fan would go through these different capacitors. Now I am going to remove this switch that selects the fan speed by cutting its wires. I will also cut the wires for the light switch. Last one. There we go. Now that the speed selector switch is removed, we can see that it uses three capacitors for selecting the speed. There is a 3 microfarad capacitor rated at 130 volts AC, a 5 microfarad capacitor rated at 130 volts AC, and another 3 microfarad capacitor rated at 130 volts AC. Now these capacitors are used in the fan controller, I think, to limit the power to the fan, thus running it at a slower speed. And these resistors, I think, are to drain the capacitors slowly so that they don't hold a charge. I made a schematic of this fan control switch, and it is more interesting than I initially thought it was. The switch itself has markings on it L, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And it corresponds with these numbers on the schematic. The L terminal of the switch is connected to the mains live wire going into the switch. It then goes out to this 1, 2, 3, and 4 terminal on the schematic. Terminal 1 is connected in series with one of the resistors on here, a 3 ohm resistor, and a 5 microfarad capacitor. Terminal 2 is connected with a 3.6 ohm resistor in series with a 3 microfarad capacitor. Terminal 3 is then connected to a 3.6 ohm resistor in series with a 3 microfarad capacitor. And terminal 4 is directly connected to the output. And the output of all of these is connected in parallel, which is then connected to the fan motor. What's also very interesting is directly connected between the main power wire coming in and the motor of the fan is a 100 kilo ohm resistor, which is probably to discharge the capacitors in some very weird way. For the light bulb dimming section, it goes to a switch with the three positions. One side is low, middle is off. The other side is high brightness. The power goes directly into one side of the switch. A diode is in the other side, and the bulb is in the middle. When the switch is set to high brightness, it connects power directly from the incoming power straight to the light bulb. However, if the switch is set to low, it connects the incoming power through a diode to the light bulb. What this does is only gives one half of the AC sine wave to the light bulb, making it light up at basically half brightness, although this is definitely not the best way to do this. So I've set up this little experiment where I've connected wires to the switch's terminals. Power from the bench power supply is connected to the L terminal of the switch, and terminals 1, 2, 3, and 4 are connected to these LEDs. These three LEDs are connected to terminals 1, 2, and 3, and the red one is connected to 4. If I turn the switch to high, only terminal 4 gets powered. If I turn the switch to medium, terminals 1, 2, and 3 all get powered. Turn it to low setting 1, only terminals 1 and 2 get powered. If I turn it to the low setting, only terminal 1 gets power. So what the switch is doing is connecting more of these capacitor and resistors in parallel to allow more power to go through the fan. But anyways, this was inside of a ceiling fan speed controller switch. Make sure to subscribe for more videos.